When I met you in that internship class, I could have never guessed how much better you'd make my life. I always wanted to marry someone who would make me better. I also just got back from the gym, so that's why I look like a mess. I'm trying to do things to surprise Britt, things that she would appreciate that I genuinely probably wouldn't do because maybe I'm not the most perfect husband, but I try to be a good husband. But there's things that, like, I think she appreciates that I don't do as often as I could or should. And now, obviously, I'm going to try to surprise her things. So right now, I'm going to go to the grocery store. And I'm gonna buy her flowers because she loves having flowers on the counter. Tanner asked if I just got in a fight and that's why I was getting flowers, and I said, no, dude, I'm beating the any of that. I'm just trying to be a good husband. So anyways, got some flowers and gonna go see what else I can get. She loves these things. So here we go. She just texted me, where are you? You should be home. So on my way home. Some thoughts. There's not much of a difference between a really, really good husband and an average husband. I'm not saying I'm one or the other, but I'm thinking just to get these flowers, it literally took like 10 extra minutes and just me to think about what I could do to make Britt happy. Sometimes when you get married, you're always thinking about your kids and yourself, and sometimes you forget about your partner.
Hello.
Hi.
What? What? Well, I like this video and this week already.
Trying to get extra brownie points today. Britt loves when I make this sandwich for her. I feel like I'm a sandwich master as of lately. So I'll video me making it, but Britt did make fresh sourdough. So this isn't even me just being extra nice. This is me just trying to take care of my wife. And I don't know if it's considered an extra nice thing to do or not, but I'm gonna make her a favorite sandwich because she's been working hard this morning. I've got a bunch of work that needs to keep getting done, and technically it's her day for food. So I'm gonna try to hook her up with a good sandwich so she can be pumped.
This is what dreams are made of.
Hi, fam. Okay, so we got Kurt and I. We just got done dropping off some Valentines for our friends. But since we're doing a week of like doing surprise service for each other, Connor and I, and he's already upped me 2 times already today. He made me a sandwich and he bought me flowers and a smoothie this morning before I've even done literally anything for him. He's crushing it and I feel bad. So I'm gonna go get him his favorite acai bowl. He's taking a nap right now because he's not feeling super good. So I'm gonna go get him his favorite acai bowl and surprise him with it when he wakes up. Should we get Dada his favorite acai bowl? Bonsai bowls? He's gonna love this. I'm sticking everything in me not to just eat it myself and act like, oh. But service week, guys, service week. He's gonna love it. It's actually been so fun because Connor and I used to do things like this for each other all the time, like surprise each other with things. But I just feel like the phase of life we're in right now, we're just so focused on our kids that like we sometimes forget to focus on each other.
Sometimes when you get married, you're always thinking about your kids and yourself, and sometimes you forget about your partner.
Doing those cute things for each other, so this has been really fun already. I wanna hear what everybody is doing for Valentine's, because the day this video comes out will be Valentine's Day.
Okay, crew, we're home. We're gonna surprise Dada. Oh my gosh, what do you think he's gonna say?
I don't know.
I think he's gonna say, what?
You hear him?
Yes.
Is that for me?
It's for Dada.
A whole bowl.
I just got the kids down for bed and Connor is at like a guy's night. So I'm gonna do his dishes while he's gone.
We have like different roles that we have. We posted this in our last YouTube video, and I do all the laundry and Connor usually does the dishes, but.
Oh my gosh.
Guys, that gecko just literally gave me a heart attack.
Oh my gosh. Thing just actually gave me a heart attack, made the weirdest sound.
Anyways, back to what I was saying. I'm gonna do his dishes for him and surprise him when he gets home that they're all done, because I know he was not looking forward to this huge pile of dishes, and I'm not either. You're not supposed to be home.
I'm not looking. I won't.
You're not supposed to see it.
Let me finish my other surprise.
Almost done. Do you see it?
Oh my gosh, it's spotless.
Yep. Yours truly. Love you.
So I'm going to return this flower pot. These two flower pots that Britt bought for the new house at Target. But I've also been talking to her about the new, I think they're called AirPod Maxes, or the headphones that are noise canceling over the ears. I think this is going to be my ultimate present to her, because she works all the time. And I used to have noise canceling headphones, and she used them, and then the boys kind of broke them. Anyways, I think it'd be perfect for her to be working inside the home with headphones on and not hearing anything, not feeling the stressors of like, oh, what's going on with inside the house. So anyways, gonna see if they have any here at Target. Just thought of this on the drive over here, and if they do, she might be getting them. All right, just returned the pots, go into the electronics section quickly before an appointment I have. Honestly, I don't understand why girls love Target so much. It's just too big, too many things. We struck out pretty hard. No one has any. They're not gonna be delivered by February 14th. It says February 28th. Anyways, we'll see what we figure out. But now I'm going to my appointment, and so I struck out on trying to be nice.
Today is Wednesday, and Connor has been at his pre-op appointment all day for his surgery that he's getting a week from today. And poor guy, he was so nervous. He said that they had to draw his blood and he almost passed out. He said his ears were ringing for like 3 minutes. He hates needles and blood and like getting his blood drawn in doctor's offices in general. So I was thinking that to make it a little better for him today, I would surprise him with a note that he should go surfing when he gets home. I know, I'm sure he's gonna get back and be like, oh, I know you have a lot of work, I'll watch the kids. But instead, I'll watch the kids and he should go surfing. Tell us, this is your pre-op post-interview.
I feel a little embarrassed that it couldn't be tough on a little blood draw. I felt
you look like a cute little second grader with a name tag.
I was scared. I had to put my mask over my face so I couldn't see anything, and I just sat there. I was like, is it done?
Coco! Okay, well, we have a surprise for you, so check your office.
I see a lot of IRS forms.
Yeah, it's not that.
Oh, I have a Kindle. Hey Coco, I know it's been a bad day. Here's a coupon for you to go surfing. I'll watch the kids.
Are you gonna go? I feel like I'm about to like present a college essay or something.
I am so excited to share with you
my
letter. So as you guys have seen, all week we've been doing nice things for each other to make Valentine's Day special, and today we wanted to write each other letters. Just to share how much we love each other.
You're so serious about it.
I'm just excited to share my letter.
This is like, as I was writing it, I'm like, sounds like a vow.
I know, I feel like we're getting married again.
But I wish we would have done vows at our wedding. Honestly, if I could go back, I would do vows.
Maybe
we redo our wedding. Are you down?
I am.
Are you actually down?
Okay, who's first? Rock, paper, scissors for you? Rock on the shoot or the rock,
paper, scissors? Just rock, paper, scissors.
Okay, rock, paper, scissors.
You can't even see your hands. Oh. You have to lift it higher.
Rock, paper, scissors. Rock, paper, scissors. So what do you want to do?
You go first.
Okay.
Actually, I'll go first. I go first. Okay. Why are you already tearing up? I haven't said anything.
I'm not tearing up. I'm not tearing up.
Okay. Dear Coco, happy Valentine's Day.
I really can't believe it's been 7 years since we met and you asked me to be your girlfriend on the beach at Three Arch Bay in California. I knew from the moment.
Why? I don't know why I'm an emotional guy lately. Maybe really because of the blood draw yesterday.
Just thinking about it. All right. I knew from the moment I met you that you were different from the other guys I had dated. You truly had it all, and I couldn't stand being apart from you. I still feel the same way about you and I did as I did back then, and I still get butterflies when I see your name pop up on my phone. Who says the honeymoon phase has to end? I've grown to love you even more as I've watched you become a dad twice. The way your heart has expanded for our two little boys and the love that you show them every day is unmatched. You are truly the best companion I could have picked, and I'm eternally grateful we found each other. Thanks for always picking me up on my sad days and laughing with me through the good times. We've been through so much of life together, and I can't wait for many more years to come.
I like that. I love you. Okay.
I can't believe you're already crying.
I'm going to be, I don't even know where to begin. When I met you in that internship class, I could have never guessed how much better you'd make my life. I always wanted to marry someone who would make me better, who was a go-getter, who was beautiful on the inside and out, and who'd be an amazing mom. I think I hit the jackpot. You're all that, and so much more. I've been thinking lately about our life, and I feel like we're living our dream. I remember talking with you about what life would look like if and when we got married, and I couldn't have dreamed up a better life for us. Yes, we have struggles and things don't seem great at times, but I wouldn't choose any other partner to do life with. I love you so much.
That's so sweet, babe. Wow.
And a really nice heart. Art.
Do you see it? Art.
Anyways, I love you. We hope you all have a wonderful Valentine's Day.
Yeah, the best Valentine's Day. Don't forget to make it special.
I got you. Don't look.
I'm scared.
Nope, don't look. Got you these.
You got me the AirPods?
Yeah.
What?